What's up? What's up, everybody? Welcome to day 255. Wicked Songbringer, 255 days into making this video game. It's actually been a whole year. As of right now-ish. But yeah, 255 is a really special day. If anybody's played Zelda 1 and you've gotten all the rupees you can, you know it's a special day. That's right, programming today. Marza, greetings.
Greetings.
Hey. Greetings. Belzeo. I'm still working on this boss, and man, he's gotten us so much funner. Check this out. Wait. Let me put his life back up. I was working on his life for a second. Let me just do two things. Let's turn that down. Put this back. You should. Yeah. Bopfu is here. Yes, it's 8-bit day today. 255. So last night I wrote this awesome music for... Awesome music. Sorry. Last night I wrote some music. Gainer Roman, what's up, man? Hello, welcome to the stream. Turned out to be really fun, actually. Yeah, that's the goal. The whole point of this is for this guy to be super duper fun. But adding the music really helped, and also the sound effects for him. Now these guys have got sound effects. See that? He totally speeds up when he gets low on himself. He's actually difficult to beat. So I hope he's just about the right difficulty, you know? This is like right when you very first get the sword, you should have full health, you're about to fight him. So one of the next things I want to do is get that missile, all his explosions to look better. Clock, what's up, Clock? The boxes? Okay, yeah, those are not done with the art yet. I want to draw some different boxes for those. But they're gonna just be life. So, you know, if you open up the box, if you have the sword, you can attack the box, open it up, just like any kind of crate or whatever, you get some health out of it. Yeah. Yeah, I don't want it to be super duper difficult, but I want it to be challenging enough that it's fun. But I do recognize that the player is this is the very first time the player even gets the sword. So, yeah, I don't know. I got to strike some balance there. What I need to do is have less health for this guy. Unless you're on permadeath mode, maybe there should be this on permadeath mode. This guy should be way more difficult. Okay, so I'm gonna get back into working on him, and the next thing I want to do is work on is the explosions and stuff like that. So I'm gonna turn that his health back off. Turn this velocity back on, so when the hearts and everything come, or the teeth come flying out. Yeah. Mm-hmm. How are you guys doing? Happy Friday. Happy day 255. I forgot. So now he's just spitting out health and it all comes flying out to the right. Oh, it looks like I can't even pick these up. Can't even tell. Huh. Oh, Marza. Marza, you gotta check out Botfu. Oh, it didn't work. Damn. Oh, no, that's a good idea. I like that. I like that, Pedro. Bafu is the best. Marza, where'd you go, man? You're missing out on Bafu. Oh, he gets it. Nice. You got it. What's up, Peta? Ooh, status dash S. Wow. Yeah, Boogie, dude. Now it's tits, man. Super tits. Dude, I love Bafu. Bafu. Too bad I already have a fiance, Bafu. 15 second, not bad. Ooh, there's a poll. Wait. Nice, dude. Whoa. What's the pull command? Ah. Yeah, totally super tits, man. Mm-hmm. Bafu's super tits. Oh, seconds. Option. Dude, this is so much fun. All of us are gonna be like, ah, Bafu. Yeah. Always tits. Both option one and two. So this spits out those teeth, the life hearts and everything. Right here, creates the item life. Why is this DRAND F should be 0 to 1? Looks like we need a breakpoint right here. Enable that. Option one, super tits is the winner. Dude, it's so good, man. Bafu. Alright, so this velocity X, velocity Y, both positive. Oh, what happened there? Positive. No wonder. No wonder, man. This is returning a po- it's always giving a positive velocity to this X. So that explains why it's always shooting out the health to the right. So why is it always positive? This DRAND F should be. Oh, this is Q dot X plus equals. Oh, yeah, yeah, that should be fine. Oh, okay, it's adding the Q to the P, and this is the, all right, all right. So I'll make another vector with both of these that we're going to need. And then add it to Q. Q is the position, V is the vector. All right, that should work. Should work, man. So now it's gonna spew out life to the left and the right. Nice. Oh. Did it? Wait, wait. Nice. Right on, man. Cool. Play with that later. So can I vote for Mars's thing? Uh-huh. For the command or for the vote? Oh. Okay. Right. Yeah. Okay, cool. This is a great one, actually. Just try and just do that. He doesn't like it. Bapu doesn't like us. There we go. Now we got lives coming to all angles. Beautiful. Beautiful. Okay, so I want the blood as well. The blood to just cover a more random area. Now, right now, all that blood was piling up in the same position there. It's Twitch's fault. Twitch is blocking the responses? What? Twitch, what? Does it think it's spam or something? turned out really good, actually. Okay, great. Now, okay, we also want to put on these explosions again. And it creates all this blood. But the blood needs to go, the blood needs to, definitely needs more. Here's the position. Max width, max height. What is the... Each blood particle needs to be more... Need to jump out more random. Yeah, spam filtering, right. Legit works. Oh, look. It worked that time. Ah, okay. Well, this explains it. The blood is set to be within a certain box and start position. Alright, so let's subtract a little from that height. And make the size a little. Wait a minute. Explosion size, explosion size. Ah, this is all back to the explosion size. So wider. Maybe same height, I guess. Let's see. Higher that time when I subtracted from its height. That's super crazy, man. But I think I liked being wider like that. That was actually really nice with the wideness. Let's go even wider. Oh, minus. I think I'd rather do plus minus than minus plus. See it again. Play it again, Sam. Sit your ass back down at the piano and play us a tune. Thank you. lot more random chaos going on here. Very cool. Oh, I know what to do. I know what to do. Okay, so we're still getting a super duper patterned type blood, right? This blood is landing exactly in this certain box right here. I want a random chance for that blood to just go outside of the box. Oh, Botfu failed you. What's up, Rocket Bunny? Welcome to the stream, man. Yeah, I think it'd be nice to do it right here in the blood. So blood has a certain size, or max width, max height. Yeah. Let's do if drand F01. How you doing today, Rocket Bunny? What's new, man? Yeah, so let's do a random chance that it's just gonna double, or maybe not quite double, maybe. We'll blend in the phi ratio there. Nice, yeah, cool. What's that? You don't have to tell me if you wanna keep it a secret or announce it or something. Announce it. Officially. Why is that? Grounded. Right on. He's joking, you know that, right? So, yeah, alright, so it takes the initial position, adds straight to the height. Oh, plus initial height. The vector. Oh, this vector has nothing to do with the height? What the hell is max height even used for? Oh my god. I made a really cool change last night to the game. I know, shit. What the hell happened? Ah, damn. Damn. I have no idea what motivates people to do that kind of stuff. Huh. Whoa. Huh. Why? Oh man, there's hostages too. Whoa. I'm working on this boss still from yesterday. So he's coming along really well. Got some music written for him last night. I actually made a really important change to the game. So the game always felt a little bit laggy to me. And if any of you guys played the alpha version, you'll have felt it too, you know? There was a tiny bit of lag whenever you hit an enemy. And they get knocked back. In fact, I'll show you exactly what I'm talking about. There's one line of code that made all the difference in making the game feel really responsive. Let me get to that line of code and I'll comment it out for now. And I'll play this boss and he'll probably kill me. Because it's really hard to fight with a lag, you know what I mean? Even a tenth of a second lag from where your input goes to affecting the screen or whatever can really, really affect everything. So let's make this guy hard to fight again. And I took out the code which made it less, or which made it the game more responsive. So now it's back to its old laggy self. And what happens is basically when you attack an enemy and you hit an enemy, they get knocked back usually. It's kind of random, but sometimes they get knocked back, sometimes they don't. But the thing is, you can hit an enemy, and for a whole tenth of a second, the enemy can still continue moving towards you. So that means that there's a whole tenth of a second where the enemy, where your input really didn't matter to stop the enemy. Right? See that right there? That was a really good example. I hit the enemy and they still kept going for that tenth of a second and it hit me again. That just happened right there. And he kicked my ass. Because of that, just because of that little tenth of a second. What's up, JFK? Welcome, 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 man. So if I put this back in, what this is now going to do is whenever you hit an enemy, it immediately goes and stops the enemy in its tracks, clears any input that the enemy might have had right then, and then it schedules the knockback to occur a tenth of a second later. So basically, you've stopped an enemy in its tracks whenever you connect the sword with the enemy. So the game feels much more responsive, and you can fight an enemy like this much better. Because you're not, you don't have that whole tenth of a second to get stuck. And I'm working on a mini boss fight here. I made some music last night, made a lot of improvements to make the game a little more fun. And that's the whole goal. I'm working on getting the game ready for this Indie Cup coming up in San Francisco, December 10th. There's going to be about 30 different games presenting there in the Indie Cup. Songbringer is going to be one of them. And one of those games, eight of the games will actually become finalists in a competition. And one of the games will actually win a $10,000 prize. So my goal is to make the game more fun. Until then, you know, everything I can do to possibly make the game more fun. And this thing last night with stopping the enemy in its tracks whenever you hit them actually makes the game way more fun. It just feels like the controls are like instantaneous now rather than having any delay or lag. Yeah, thanks. I wish it was that easy, but there's actually judges there, so I have to convince the judges, you know, that the game is fun, marketably viable. Like, there's four different criteria or whatever the games are going to be judged on. So we'll see. And there's a lot of other great-looking indie games going to be there. I've already seen a lot of them, and I'm blown away. I'm like, whoa, there's some stiff competition here. So I have no idea whether the Songbringer could win it, but it would be super cool if it did, because then I would be set, be able to make this game super dope for the next 6 months. Instead of having to kind of like rush it out or whatever and try and make money. Slip a big bill right in their pockets. That could work. All right, so this last little thing to make. V, okay, here it is. V is the vector. Man, this whole max width thing. This method is messed up. I'm not sure if I need to fix it right now. Yeah, was it? Nice. Ooh, Slovakia was sunny. Rainy up north, sunny down south. Man, this method is confusing. All I want to do is make it so it can sometimes go twice as high. I guess I would need to modify size. And that would give me a different initial height, different vector. Yeah, I think that might work. Let's try that. Whoa, what was that noise? Oh, thanks, Kurzajin. Thanks for hosting, man. Yeah, cheers. Okay, let's see how this thing goes now. What's up, Avenable? Awesome, man. Well, you're going to see it right now. I'm going to play a little bit of it. So this is where you first get the sword. This is like a Zelda 1 type game. You get the sword, and then this guy is he warps in and magically appears to fight him. So I'm working on the explosions for him when he dies right now. And next I'm going to work on the entrance, so when he actually comes on the screen, he's going to warp, and so I'll be working on that next. See, he's actually kind of hard. That did actually spread out the blood a little bit better. So, I think it can go higher though, size that height times 3 or something. What's up, Froom? Welcome to the stream, man. It's going great. Working on this mini boss fight right now. I was just thinking, right then, it would be really cool if this guy had a different kind of skin, so he looked really damaged. I'm just gonna draw it right now. So we'll just, this is called Ra's Idol right now. I'm gonna make it Ra's Damaged Idol, something like that. So you'll have a different skin. So when he gets down to like half health or whatever, he's going to gain this skin, damaged skin. Right, and I'm thinking this triangle thing here needs to be part of the same layer. This will make this way easier. Merge these two layers. Oh, what happened here? 10% Y. Oh. These are all Propagate Frame 1. Propagate Frame 1! Seriously. Happen again. Lame. Oh, because whenever I merge these two layers, all of a sudden they turn in. Whatever. Alright, just merge them anyways. Put these all back at 100%. Even mess up the animation, but oh well. God damn. Okay, so I want this guy to look damaged. I'm gonna take this tool and like squish in. Actually, no, let's squish in this side. That looks awesome. And we'll give him some kind of like, I'm gonna draw a pure white at first. This is gonna look weird, but some like cracks. Man, that is a pretty bad earthquake though. 7.0. Yeah. Start getting above 5 and that gets scary. Whoa. Is it the 13th? Oh my god, it is. Whoa. Sorry, I never know what day it is. What's up, J2? KO, what's up, dude? Welcome to the stream. I'm working on making this guy look damaged now. This is a boss I'm working on. I got a little skin. Hopefully this will make him look really cool. So when he gets down to like low health, he'll become like this. Man. Oh, it's Saturday for you. Where are you at, Soren? What time is it? Is it late already? It's 3:30. Oh, it's definitely Saturday in Europe some places, huh? Oh. Right. Oh, good point. You're talking about Japan? Oh, you're in Denmark? Oh yeah, it's late for you guys, huh? Yeah. Rest in peace. Yeah, this is looking good. Okay, so I'm just going to get this animation fixed up so it's not broken anymore, and we'll export it out. Looks like a flying acorn. Yeah, this is a boss. Let me show you what this guy looks like. So I'm making a new animation for him so that he's damaged when he gets low health. But I'll show you what this is I'm working on. It's a boss fight. This guy's a boss. So he actually is going to warp inside here into this room after you pick up the sword. It's the very, very beginning of the game. I really shouldn't have a B item or an X item or a Y item. At this point, you just have the sword. But anyways, you have to fight this guy as a boss. It shows up right away. I'm kind of taking a risk here, putting such a difficult enemy right at the very beginning of the game. I mean, he's not super difficult, but he is. You kind of got to figure out the trick. But the point is to excite the player. This should make you feel like, give you kind of an example of what there is to expect in this game, why it's fun. You know, it shows you what's fun about this game right away, within the first few minutes of playing the game. So yeah, that's what I'm working on. I'm making him some art for him so he looks cool when he's damaged. Nice, yeah, I'm glad. Yeah, I might go and actually, I want to add something else to the song. Right at the very end, I got this idea for one little sound effect which could really help the music be even better. But I hope this doesn't ruin the stream or anything. But yeah, this is the boss song I wrote in Ableton last night. I just noticed that I need to actually put a tempo marker in here. How the hell do I do a tempo change? There, insert time signature change. The old song was 69.5. Whoa, that really, what did you do? What did I do? Oh, it didn't work. Don't change that. Oh, don't change the time signature. That's not what I meant. I didn't want to change the tempo. Oh well, I'll do this later. But this is supposed to be 91 beats per minute, and this other section is supposed to be 69 beats per minute. Oh well, figure that out later. So let's try this guy out. Should start there. Actually, let's verify that. I think this might be, this animation changed as soon as I merged those two layers. So I want to make sure this first frame, he starts at the same, yeah, four pixels off the ground. Yeah, 69. You know why I chose that tempo? Of course you do. So it goes down, down, up, 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 down. Okay. And he starts 4 pixels off the ground. Good. All right. So down here, this is... Oh, we might as well merge these two as well if we're going to merge them all. Merge. Don't propagate. Just merge. Oh, wait. This layer is actually going to be better to have as a separate layer for now. Okay. Oh, another thing I want to do is make Jib more active when you're fighting a boss. Right now, he doesn't have much to do because he doesn't have much to scan. But I want to make him so he runs away from the boss. Like, he goes, and like, he gets scared of the boss. So hopefully that'll be fun. Down a pixel, next one. Down, down. This one's up. Ah. down, up, 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 down. Good. All right. And let's get this guy's got to be lined up perfectly now. Where does it mess up? One frame is off. Where? What frame is that? Oh, this frame. Messed up, man. This frame too? Oh no. I put them all in the wrong spot. Oh, it does look cooler. There, yeah, he looks damaged. Very cool. Raw's idle damaged. Export, render this. Sheets foes, idle damaged. Okay. I'm trying to see heroes. When, oh, okay. So there's no dash in all of these. All right. So that should be called Rod's Idle Damage, just like that. And then this I can rename as well. Save as Raz Idle Damaged. Okay, and when we're fighting this guy, he should have another skin type. Forget how to do skins again. Oh yeah, all I need to do is specify a dash for the animation. Yeah, okay. So he also has these. So he has idle dash damaged. And he has run and run damaged. Now, when his health gets low, where the hell is that? HP charge. Here we go. If his speed is less than 1.5, HP is less than 0.5. Let's do a skin command. Skin. Skin damaged. Or dash damaged, I guess. Now, I don't think I have this as a command yet, so I need to add this behavior to be able to set a skin. Yeah, there's no skin command. Okay, no problem. All right, let me put away this graphics tablet, and we'll do new type of command behavior. You got touching, last touching, skin. Touching skin. 69 touching skin. All right, and then we hook up the word for that. Put this in the dictionary for parsing behaviors. Okay, behaviors, skin. And then we'll add it to the system and we're done, ready to do that. Whoa. Hopefully that's good news. Whoa, whoa. What's going on here? Hey, thanks for following. Okay, so in the system for K behavior, like it's kind of like a dir. Dir. Spawn, jump, launch, melee. We'll put this behavior skin here. I love how he's got the slop. E.render.skin. Sterval 0. Howdy, Born a Snipe. What's up, man? He's all right. It's freaking awesome. Everybody that's joined the stream or on the stream right now, Boogie programmed this awesome IRC bot for Twitch bot basically, that's called BotFu, and you can, he does commands. He's super cool. Boogie wrote it in C sharp with dot, some kind of .NET thing. Yep, and you can type exclamation point help to get help on what he can do. All right, so we got that hooked up. So this enemy guy has a different skin possible, but let's, I have to fight him and get down to half health before he can, turn on his goose skin. I can't. League champ, so close. Wow, it's been an hour already. Okay, I really do got to get to the part where he warps in next. But let's see if the skin works. Hopefully it does. We should have Sterval 0. Dash damaged, yeah. Looks like it worked. Skin, yeah. It should work, hopefully. Oh man, dude, my mouse is messed up. So messed up. It won't, what the hell's going on? Dude, nobody should upgrade to El Capitan. It's so bad. I feel really bad for the people at Apple. Like, what the hell is going on? Ugh, never mind. Yeah. Oh, that works. Left click works. Okay, let's play again. Nice! Yeah, he's all damaged. He's super fast. OK. Okay, and definitely his animation with the cracks, or the, yeah, the cracks are a bit much, so maybe that'll only be like 1% or something. But he does look crazy cool like that, all damage. And I like how it was implemented entirely with the behavior too. Oh, despite being almost dead, he kills me. It's really hard. Man, I don't know. What the hell? Oh, I can't. Oh. What's up? Okay, let's try this with a much lower percentage. Maybe 1. Of course, the mouse isn't going to operate. That's 1%. There's 2%. I'm thinking 2% maybe. 5 was way too high, so let's do 2%. The taskbar doesn't even work now. Dude, I'm like dead in the water. I can't do anything basic. Yeah, right now. I don't know, that's a really good question. Oh, all I want to do is go file, render video. Wait a minute. I did do some new command or something like that for saving, rendering video. Is it? Yes, that's it. All three of those plus S. Foes, render that, replace that. Yeah, I mean, it just happened, man. It just happened. Whoa, there's more attacks? More Y height on those explosions though. Oh man, somebody's in the stadium. Meh. Oh no. Oh wow. Oh my god, yeah, that is quite fortunate. Man. Wow. What? No, this is still messed up. Okay, yeah, let's play around with an animation now. I'm gonna start drawing something for this guy to warp in. It's about time this guy warped. Dude, it is really hard to use a Mac computer when your mouse doesn't work. My God, maybe I should unplug it. Hold on. What if I unplug this and plug it back in? Huh, mouse? You want to work then? Nope. How do I just select a freaking file then? Here. My God, nothing works. Is horrible. I might have to reset the computer and just start the stream again. I'm trying, man. They killed the two attackers and the hostages are safe. Whoa. Hey, you know what works? My graphics tablet. I'm just gonna stick to my graphics tablet right now. Fuck the mouse. So there's the animation for this guy. For Rock doing his teleport. So we've got one frame. Where the red and blue come out a little bit. Two, three, four, and then back in. Thanks, bunny. All right, so I'm gonna call this one Roz teleport in. Oh no, yeah, that's totally, yeah, totally a pixel art. Yeah. Okay, so what's the size of this animation? 104 pixels tall, 52 wide. Let's get this one to be 104. Put this guy on the bottom. Zoom out a little. Put this gray background on. There, we're ready to do this. He's got some limitations right now, Bob Fu. I know, right? Yeah, that's another big thing, right? People are very quick to blame. It's just if there's actually a documentary on that, on how people did this kind of frenzied search for who tried to do the Boston Marathon bombing, and people found the wrong people, or something like that, and some innocent people got wrongly accused of having done those bombings. So there's a whole documentary on that, on how these people got wrongly accused because of s trail on the internet or something. All right, yeah, let's get he's not gonna hover or anything, so I'll take out these frames. We don't need the bolt, we don't need the bolt glow, we don't need the tri-copy. We can merge these two layers. There we go. Now we'll get a red and a blue layer. Yeah, capital C, man, capital C. You can also just copy paste. Sorry. I messed it up with the wrong copy paste there. That was funny. Come on, copy paste right, yo. BC Warrior. I'm typing it out. It's the only way it's gonna work right now. Bob Fu, jumping in. Right. Right, that's wrong. What happened? How did I do the other blue? Pretty sure I did a different color. Oh no, I didn't. Oh, okay. So these definitely does have like a. Yeah. I know. I messed up on one of these. I'm not sure which though. Oh, wait. The whole point of that, I wanted to check this. See that? Oh, it is the straight red, but it's not quite all the way bright. 74 bright. This is straight blue? Nope, it's not. It's hue 219. Yeah, he does that. He does that. Yes, this is stereoscopic version. Starting it right now. Look at that. It automatically did 219 for me. Hey, what's up, PMC? Welcome to the stream, man. How you doing? I'm working on this guy teleporting in now. I'm thinking his energy should be black, too, so he... has like a black type of... light beam or whatever. What is it? Sorry, I'm on a no link clicking diet right now. I can't click links or else my computer will crash. The Shane breaking challenge. Yeah, I'm liking this. That might do for a first frame. It worked. Do another frame. So I'm animating a teleport animation for this enemy. And I'm almost done with the frames, so I can put this all together in a second. This is like, don't need these pixels anymore. Did it? Well, I hope not. Nice. What's the game status? Wow. Oh. Bonfu. Let's see how this goes. Man.